Hey YouTube, well I'm back with yet another car story. This is a car that I've known about for 35 years. It belongs to a friend of mine who's owned it since high school. I've known him, you know, again 35 years. And the car has been in storage for a while. It does run. He does fire it up every now and then, but it's about to get a complete facelift because we're going to put this car back on the road. It's basically undrivable right now. It needs a lot of stuff. But we're going to go take a look at it because every car has got a story, and this is another interesting one. And this is just the beginning of what's going to happen with this car. But let's go take a look at this car and meet the owner. Today to check out something really special. I'm with a friend of mine I've known for 35 years, Darren Nason. Man, it's good to see you.
You too.
Behind us is a very special car. You've owned this since?
This is my second car.
Your second car.
Second
ever.
Car. I think okay. You know the first one.
Yeah, let's not talk about that, right? We'll get into that somewhere down the
sometime,
line.
Yeah.
What year did you buy this?
85 to 86. Okay. It was kind of my, I think in my... high school, I was probably about 10th or 11th grade.
Okay.
Somewhere around there.
And tell us what it is.
Oh, it's my SS 396. Well, at the time when I bought it, 396, got the 4-speed Muncie in it. Funny thing was, is I, after I was...
To El Camino.
El Camino. Yeah, you can't see the, right now, you probably can't see the whole car. It could look like a Chevelle right now, but yeah, it's the El Camino. And yeah, this has been my girl. This is my high school sweetheart, basically, so... Bought her. I remember the day she was red and black when I had her, and went out to Glendale to pick her up for $2,500. And came driving home. Had a couple buddies back in the day. I think people would hop in the back. You know, back when the Subarus had the seats in them.
Yeah, yeah.
I guess so. People hop in the back, and I remember on Ventura Boulevard we'd be driving, and the car stalled. And I guess I thought maybe it was a battery issue or whatever. So we had people on Ventura Boulevard hopping out of the back, pushing it to jump start the thing to get it fired up. Yep. Again, and then took it into auto shop, and we found out it's just an issue with the ignition system. So what I ended up doing is, back in the day, they didn't have push button starts like all the cars today do. So I did that about 35 years ago. I got a push button start now. My ignition doesn't turn on, but it goes to on position, and I got my little
so
button.
So since day one, that's the way it's been?
It's been since day four.
Day four.
I couldn't push it myself, so I had to rig up something, and I didn't want to, you know, you're 18 years old, you know, I didn't want to go into the, you know, the whole console and everything, so we just did the easy fix. So.
Easy fix, it's still that way today.
Exactly. Yeah.
So this car has been sitting in this spot for how long?
This spot probably about 15 years.
Okay.
And then at my other home, probably, you know, obviously another 20 years.
Okay.
15, 20.
Yeah, so she's been sitting for a while, but you managed to hang on to it all these years, which is incredible. And you said it was originally red with a black stripe,
yeah.
Black stripes, super sport stripes. Yeah. And it was originally a 396 four-speed car. What engine's in it now?
I built it. It's a 468, 454 bored out, roller cam, roller everything. I kept the same transmission in there. It was a beast. I did 13-1 back in the day. We had gas at 102 octane, so it wasn't a big deal. And actually, race gas was a super expensive $4 a gallon.
Yeah, so. Which we thought was absolutely insane.
Exactly. So, but that was manageable. So when I go, I used to do the El Camino Nationals. I used to go down. It's 1120s. I'd do 1120s at Los Angeles County Raceway back in, I don't know, probably the 90s or something when I was, got it really going nice. So got the ladder bars on the back and everything. But, it's just been fun. It's been my ride for so many years. And then I got into other things. It was tough going to the track and, you know, with power valves and plug changes. And then you had to get the trailer and I had to get a dually to tow it. And I just got too expensive for me at the time. And I just kept it, put it in the garage for a little bit, unfortunately. And it was outside probably for 7 to 10 years at my other house because I didn't have room for it. And luckily I was able to put it back in the garage. And, you know, I'm looking forward to, you know, put a little time and effort into her and get her back up to speed.
Okay, so which brings us to what's next for this car?
Next, we're going to be doing a swap out. Because it's so difficult to drive her with the gas, I tried detuning it. And
it's a 13 to 1 is a killer.
Yeah. So, like most people today, we're looking at the LS motor. So we're going to probably put an LS motor in there. I'm going to keep I still have the original heads, original manifold. I still got a lot of the original parts, which I'm going to keep, obviously. I even got the original SS rims, the, you know, spoked ones, not the rallies.
This car runs.
Oh, it runs. It drives, yeah.
Yeah, okay.
I just got to clean the, you know, I also had a hip surgery thing. It took me, you know, the hip, it's worse than just a hip surgery, but I was out of it for a year. So I haven't even fired it up in about a year and a half, unfortunately.
Which we're going to do, you know. We're going to fire this thing up before it comes apart for an engine swap.
Oh, yeah.
We're also going to do suspension on it.
Yeah.
Yeah. So we can get this thing into a driving car. So you can get in it, turn the key, take it on the road.
Yeah. Just a regular commuter now. I just want it, pump gas, get in it, fire it up, drive it around. I'm going to switch the tranny to the TKX, I believe, the 5-speed. That way I don't have to do a lot of tunnel modifications. Hopefully not. So I'll have a 5-speed, a little bit of an overdrive. It's got 411 gears in it now, so it's not too bad. It's not like 456s or anything, so should be a nice ride. I mean, it's beautiful. I love her. Can't wait to get back and put a little bit of attention into her. I know I neglected her. 100% my fault, but I just got out of cars, got into dirt bikes and razors and ATVs and playing ice hockey and stuff like that. I just kind of put her on the back burner until, you know, save up a little money. And now I'm going to be able to get her a boob job or whatever we need to do to get her up and going.
And so, what engine did you pick out for this car?
The LS3. It's the 427 stroker. It's going to have 625 horsepower and drivable, streetable. Yeah. Most important thing.
Yeah, 91 octane. Yeah.
91 octane. Just got to do the suspension. Last couple of times I took her out and, woo, taking turns. I thought, you know, that body roll is insane. Yeah. So can't wait to get that taken care of.
You got skinny tires up front for drag racing?
Not too much. I switched them back out. I used to back in the day. I had the 90-10s in the front. No, I got more normal drivable tires. I think I did that because it was sitting so long. I had to change the tires out because they're cracking and everything. So I just went with the basic tire setup. And I just don't know if I'm going to keep these center lines on or go back to the original SS rims. So like I said, they're not the rallies. They're the 69 spokes, which is pretty nice. So.
Yeah, so we're going to do front suspension, eventually the rear links.
Right.
Were you doing a brake upgrade? What was that all about?
Yeah, the part of the front end suspension is going to come with new calipers, new brakes, pistons. So okay. It's just time. I just want to just upgrade it. You know, yeah, it's going to be a little bit of a project, but those are projects are for, man. They're fun and get back into it, get dirty again and make her look pretty again and drive nice.
And you did all the wrenching on this in the first place. I mean, you built the motor, you put the motor in, all that stuff.
Built the motor, put it all in. Had you know, a great time with her. I mean, you know, growing up, you're 18 to 24. It's your life. I mean, you're on them basically wrenching all the time, tuning all the time.
Yeah. And then kids come along and life comes along and jobs come along.
But I've replaced the ball joints, the bushings before. I've replaced the gas tank before. I mean, pretty much everything. The interior. I redid the seats and things. I never had a console in this one, but it's always been a 4-speed. But I just don't have that console. It's just the carpet with the boot.
Gotcha.
Which is nice. It's fine. Give me a little more room. People actually, back in the day, we used to cram a lot of people in here when we drive. We'd actually have 5 people in an El Camino. Two in the front. I think 2 were laying down behind the back seats, and we'd go up to Nacimiento water ski. And,
oh, my God.
They're like 110 miles an hour flying up to 5. And this car's it's been around. I've had her for a long time. I've driven her for a lot. I mean, obviously, it seems now I haven't driven her more than when I had her. But, boy, when we had her, that's all we ever did was just drive and go to the street races and water skiing and
playing and having fun.
Yeah.
But now we're at the age where it's time to play and have fun again.
Have fun. And
you were lucky enough to hang on to this. You know, I mean, most of us lost our original muscle cars, you know, when we grew up. But there a few of us managed to hang on to them. You're one. Our friend Kevin Brown's another. We're gonna try. There's another car. I'm not gonna mention the car right now. I'm gonna try and film it, and we're gonna try and drag that one out of the mothballs as well. And that car's been sitting for 35 years as well.
Yeah.
But I'm gonna try and make that happen. We'll see.
Yeah.
But
I think he'll get a little motivation when he sees when we get this one back up.
I hope so. But maybe we should uncover it and dig it out and show everybody what it really looks like.
Yeah.
So you got a chance to see this car, but you're going to see more of it because we're going to do suspension coming up. He's already ordered parts, or they're about to get ordered, and then we're going to swap a motor into this thing. So make sure you like and subscribe if you want to see more like this. Thanks, Darren.
Have a good one. See you soon.